chine kumpi Pano ye vanji amazi kibida Kola kati yesu to mutengo wa
Akoba umba mwoku tunora
Kola kati yesu to chine kumpi
Pano ye vanji amazi kibida
Yesu to mutenguwa kwe
Ako ma umamu wakutu nona Chabu kisa okukorea Yesu Eya tunulula lomu saibwe Eya tutabaganya leka
Kola kati ejiro chiri kumpi
Pano ye vanji amazikira
Kola kati yesu to utenguwa
Ako maumangu mongu tunona
Kola kati ejiro chiri kumpi
The Lord has been guiding us and bringing us every time to worship Him.
Twagala okumwebaza olwa bonna ababadde basobola okujja abagenyi wamu na bekkanisa eno.
We would like to thank the Lord for all that have been coming, the visitors, and together with the members of this church.
Mu bingi bye tuyize mu
amongst all the things that we have learned.
Katonda atukulembedde okuyiga ebintu ebiwerako.
The Lord has guided us to learn quite a number of things.
Abaliwo mujjukira ku sabbiti eyasooka twayiga ku the husband's store.
Those who were around, you heard us when we had a discussion ku lugendo lw'abaami.
Omukyalo omu yatambula n'agenda mu supermarket emu yali etunda abaami.
One lady had to go to a supermarket that sells husbands.
Yali agenze ngayagala naye okusobola okwefunira yo owuwe.
He went there because he wanted also to buy a husband.
Kumyalire tanu ejali ku kizimbe ekyo mwali abami.
on the five floors that were on that building where the
husband was.
Every floor had different type of husbands. We saw this lady going to all the floors and did not get any. We saw two things that making a choice is not easy.
Olwalero tuli echo chetuli olwalero olwebyo byetwakola olwajjo byetwasalawo ne byetwalonda mwebyo byetuyisemu.
You are what you are because of the choices that you have made and what you have decided to.
Twagenda maso ne tulaba ntira si kyangu kumatizibwa bulamu bwanse eno.
We also noted that it is not easy to be satisfied by the challenges in this world.
Tutambude mu nsi eno tulide bingi naye teri n'ekimu kigenda kukumatiza.
We have walked all over this world, we seen so much, but nothing is actually going to satisfy us.
Tuwalaba nti ekintu kikumatiza tonakifuna.
We also noted that things satisfy you before you acquire.
Oyayana techikuli mu ngalo.
You learn for it.
Okukolerera tochirina.
You work for it when you don't have.
Nebuli womala okukituukako ogenda okufuna obutali bwakyo.
You don't find it satisfying.
Omuwala ayinza okubanga mulungi n'ofa nnyo omukwane.
A lady can be so beautiful and you really long to have that.
Omusajja ayinza okubanga wa kitiibwa n'ofuba.
A gentleman can be so good that you fight to get that
girl.
But as soon as they get home, then you realize that it was nothing. It's all worth nothing.
Twalaba nti Mukama yekka y'asobola okufuula ekintu ekitaliimu okubeera
ekyomwenna.
Twaddamu ne tunuulira ensonga eno yali ekwata ku kwaŋŋanga entiisa y'okufa.
And the next lesson was on facing the scare of death.
Okwaŋŋanga entiisa y'okufa twakiraba nti kye kimu ku bintu bye tulina okutunuulira kubanga obanga waliwo ekikakafu mu nsi eno bwe kwe kufa.
The tackling death is one thing that we have to look at and one of the things that we know can happen to us or will happen to us is death. We are all walking the shadow of death. Means that there is something definite that is
there.
And at any time it may come to us. The Bible says that even if I walk through the shadow of death, the Bible says that even if I walk through the shadow of death, the Bible says that even if I walk through the shadow of a
death,
I shall fear no evil because you're with me. Ezekiel chapter 33 verse 11. Tell them that as I am alive, the Lord says, there is no happiness that I gain by the righteous death. But I would like the evil to change and come out of the evil doing. To be alive. And he goes on and says, change and change from your evil doing. Why
do
you actually like the death? The house of Israel.
Kabaka Daudi akungubagira mu kuba general be.
King David was mourning one of his generals.
Mu Samuel chokubiri Yesu la 3:33 agamba.
In 2 Samuel chapter 3 verse 33.
Kabaka nakungubagira Abuneri.
That the king started mourning Abner.
Na wigamba nti Abuneri yalifudenga.
And he said that Abner would have died like a silly person or a stupid person. There are people who die and they've died as silly people. Those are the people who think that in the world they are going to be like stones. Those are the ones who turn to their own and feel that the world is theirs. Those are the ones who walking today clearly knowing that we'll be there tomorrow. Those are the ones who don't know that they have to prepare, because what you have today is yours. They die like silly people because they don't realize that we're walking in the shadow of death. But there are people who are valuable before the Lord. Psalms chapter 116 verse 15. That in the eyes of the Lord, the death of the righteousness is a valuable thing. In Revelation chapter 14 verse 13 says that blessed are those who die in the Lord Jesus.
It
says that and I heard a voice coming from the heavens saying that those blessed are those that die in the Lord. That is how the Spirit says that their toiling is over.
Baumule kubanga ebikolwa byabwe bigenda nabo.
They can rest because their works will go with them.
Twatunulira sabiti emune tunulira twetegereze nsonge gamba njetabaza yabana bakatonda.
We looked on one Sabbath looking at the light of the children of God.
Zaburi 10:19 olwo 15 yagamba.
Psalms chapter 119 verse
105.
That your word is the light of my
life
and is the light for my path. We saw the children of Israel when they were redeemed from Egypt.
Katonda yatesa okubanunula iyo okuita mukirecho okuita musaigu mana gwendiga gwebata nebateeka ku miryango jabwe.
God planned to redeem them by putting blood on the front of their houses. But after redeeming them, after saving them, after coming from the powerful hand of King Pharaoh, as they started their journey to the promised land, the Bible says that the Lord appeared to them at mountain side, and he appreciated, he liked to give them the
commandments.
Those commandments were to guide them, was not to save them, because they had already been saved, but it was to guide them in the challenging world, a sinful challenging world which they. Those commandments was to guide them to understand the evil they
have done,
in order to reach the promised land. But many did not reach. Only two managed to reach
that.
Because the rest did not observe the commandments of
God. And the Bible says that after
God had spoken to Moses at Mount Sinai, the two tablestones which were written by the hand of God. It's the only writing that was written by God. There are some Christians who think when Jesus died at the cross, he did away with the laws of God.
But
the Bible really tells us that I did not come to do away with the laws of God. I never came to do away, but to fulfill them.
tekutuletera da kuenda kubanga eryo lyerimu kuteeka.
Brothers and sisters, the death of Christ does not lead us to fornication.
Eteka erimu ligamba
one of the commandments says
ndi katutuleta tokola tuweretanga bifananyi bilala byonna okubisinzanga.
That you should not have any evil images.
Okufa Kristo kumisalaba tekututwala kusinza bifananyi.
The death of Christ does not give us the liberty to actually worship the evil.
Okufa Kristo kumisalaba tekutuletera kugenda kuba.
The death of Christ does not give us the liberty to go and steal.
Tuchizula ndiwe wabo mateka teka tulokola.
We realize that though the commandments do
not serve us,
but they are the mirror to show
us,
and they are the one which guide us in this world. And John, First John chapter 2 verse
3
says, and this is how we know that we have understood him, when we keep God's
commandment.
He who says that I know him but does not keep the commandments
is a liar,
and the truth is not within.
Matayo yokana 14:15 nagamba tumemba munjagala munakwatanga.
John 14:15 says, if you love me you keep my commandments.
Chavagamba nti walwete kalimu elisumbwa ensi eno.
And he says there is only one commandment that keeps challenging this world.
Ye tekeri okuna.
And that is the fourth commandment. Remember the Sabbath
day.
6 days you shall keep
your work.
But the seventh day is the Lord, the day of your Lord. That day challenges people and thinking that the commandments have been done away with and the commandments have been
done.
But that commandment shows that it was there before even the commandment. Because it reminds us of the creation. God gave it on Mount Sinai. And the children of Israel kept that commandment. Christ himself observed the Sabbath.
After
his death, the disciples also observed the Sabbath. Isaiah shows that after the redemption as we go to heaven, we shall worship God on the Sabbath day. It shows us that the Sabbath is a sign of God that is still present at this time. The world is challenged because which day is the Sabbath? Is it Friday? Is it Saturday? We saw that the Bible says that it never changes. And the Easter, which we all celebrate, we know that Jesus died on Good Friday. And some of Christians do not eat any meat.
The
significance that on that day Jesus' body was crucified.
The
Saturday is a
Saturday.
And the Bible shows that that is the Sabbath. And the Easter demonstrates to us that Jesus resurrected on Sunday.
On the Easter Sunday.
And that is the first day of the
week.
So from the Bible, the Sabbath is none on any other day but the Sabbath. Hebrews chapter 4 verse 9. And that is the book which was written after
Bible and
the Bible says there is only one rest for the people of God. There is still another rest. Last Sabbath, we looked at the heading which was saying you're getting your name written in the heavenly, getting your name written in heaven.
Bible yatugamba,
the Bible says. Jesus says that let not your heart be troubled. Believe in God and believe in me. In my Father's house are many mansions to be. If it was not so, I would have told you. And I'm going to prepare the place for you. And if I'm going to prepare a place for you, I'll come again. I'll go take you where I am. Where I am, there he may be also. And the Bible goes in Philippians chapter 2 verse 3. But for us in heaven, that is where we are going to wait for the kingdom. Brothers and sisters, we are not going to be here forever. Our home is in heaven. Christ went to prepare us. He will come back to take us. Where he is, we are suffering. We are going to winter and all the challenges. But there comes a day when we will reach the promised land. With all the premised love. That is where we are. Though it is our home, and the Christ has gone to prepare the place, not all of us are going. It's only those who have taken
place.
Those who have
decided.
Christ is not going to force anyone to take him to heaven. Christ is not going to come and just take the whole church. Only those who decide to take a chance and get their name written in the books of the heaven. It is your choice, it is my choice.
Christ,
accept Christ and have your name written in the book of life. How do you get your name written in the book of life?
Yes, and Jesus said
that if you are not born again, not enter into the kingdom of
God.
We are all born by our parents.
That's the first birth.
That is the very first birth. When we are born in the first birth, the death and sin are ours. But there is a second Adam.
Adam oyo atuito kuingira mu lulio lwe.
And that Adam is calling us to go in his life. And that is the lineage. That one is a choice which you have to make.
It
says as if it's swearing that truly, truly, I say unto you,
if
a person is not born by the Spirit and water, you will never get to the kingdom of heaven. Therefore, to go into the kingdom of heaven, you have to be born again. And born by two.
Of water and of the Spirit.
Umazi no moyo.
Bible yongera maso negamba nti Yesu najja na yongera nabo nabagamba.
I've been given the power unto the world and the earth. Go and preach and reach out to the whole world and make them disciples by baptizing them in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. That is the only way we can enter into the kingdom.
Is
to be born by the Spirit. We are born by the water and the Spirit, and then we'll be worthy to go to heaven. Matthew 28:20
says,
everything that I have commanded, I am with you all the days until the end of the world. Mark 16:15, Jesus said that go unto the whole world and preach the gospel to every creature. Whoever believes and is baptized will be saved. But he who does not believe will be. Brothers and sisters, that is where that is where you get your name written in the books of
heaven.
That is where the decision is. That is where the decision is to go to heaven. heaven
or to go to heaven.
That is where you need to decide to be saved
or for the nabatiziwa.
Whoever accepts and is baptized
alirokoka
will be saved. But he who does not believe,
he will be condemned. Omukubatiziwa nekaberanga kekabonera ko kunguru akalage ekyo ekikutuseeko mu bulamu bw'obwomunda.
Baptism is an outward expression of faith in Christ Jesus and his gospel. When you, after preaching the gospel that I had we finish it with baptism. Because the Bible says, go and preach the gospel. And after hearing the gospel, and then ask them, have they accepted or they have received? And those who have accepted, they need to be baptized. And their way is salvation. Those who have refused, those who have refused, their end will be death. There is one of my sisters I spoke to and they said, Pastor, why are you trying? I'm already baptized.
I was baptized.
And I was baptized when I was a little. Baptism is one of the choices that leads us to heaven. But many of us have been playing around with it. Some people
would
think that you can even throw dust on you and then you'll be
back.
Some think you can even get a fizzy drink or like soda and you just shake it and
sprinkle
all over to everyone to be baptized. And they call that even baptism. And some of them put oil on you. And they say in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
And
some come and use the water and sprinkle it to you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. And some
will
just scare you. They actually take you to the water when you don't even know. And they just immerse you. And then they take you out and they say, and some have seen getting a red garment as a sign for
the blood of Christ.
And then you pass through in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. And then they say that one is also baptized. But the question is,
confused.
Is the Christ so much confused like that?
And
the Bible is so much
like
that you can just pick and choose whatever you want to be
it.
We inquired from the Bible and it clearly Ephesians chapter 4 verse 4 says that one body, one spirit, as we are called into one hope, one Lord, one faith, and one baptism. As the Lord is one.
And the
Bible
wants
you that it's not what you choose that can be called
baptism. Amazima, amazima.
There are many who are in church thinking that they were baptized, but they have never been baptized. Because it is only one
baptism.
And that is the baptism of the Bible. And the Bible says that he went to Galilee and reached to River Jordan.
Oh no, yes,
this Christ is the one we follow. He's going also to be baptized. How was he baptized? How did he get baptized? In Matthew chapter 3 verse 15, that Jesus says that accept now, because we need to fulfill all the righteousness. And
he accepted,
and John accepted to be baptized. In verse 16 he says, after Jesus was baptized, immediately came out of the water, and the heavens opened, and saw the Spirit of God coming like a dove.
So
he just went deep in the water and came out of the water. Baptism requires much water. It requires you to go in the water and come out of the water. Baptism is a sign of death, for dying and resurrecting. It is a sign of being born again. It requires much water, because in John chapter 3 verse 23, and when John was baptized near Salim, because there was much water, and people went there and were baptized. We need much water to be baptized. Colossians chapter 2 verse 12, when all of you were baptized, you were buried with Christ, and in the baptism you resurrected
him,
for accepting the God who resurrected him from
Christ.
So the right baptism is to be buried with Christ in water, in much water, and we come out and resurrect in a new life. Romans says that, don't you know that all that we are baptized, we baptized through the death, and it reminds us that we were buried. Have you been buried?
So we were
buried through baptism. So when Christ left,
and
his disciples went ahead baptizing, as we see in Acts chapter
8.
And Philip met someone who was uncircumcised.
Bible egamba nti mbikola batu memunana olwasa tumo mukaga nti awe bwebe yongera Filipo nga abubulira enjiri ne batuuka awali amazzi.
Acts chapter 8 verse 36, and as they were preached, they reached where there was water.
Omunawe n'agamba Filipo nti laba amazzi, kiki ekindobera okubatizibwa?
And then he told him, look, there's water, what stops me from being baptized?
Asa tumusa
verse 37. And Philip says, if you believe with all your heart, you'll be baptized. And he says that, I accept Christ as the Son of God. And he stopped the chariot. Both of them,
Philip
and the eunuch, and they went into the water. And Philip, when you are baptized, the person who baptized you, did he go out in the water as well? Jesus says that if you are not born of the water, you will not see the kingdom of heaven. They have just duped us.
Immediately after
coming out of the water, the Spirit of God took Philip And the eunuch did never saw him again.
Amazi wegali wano tugenda kubatiza olwale.
The water is here, we're going to baptize today.
Mumazi amanji.
In the deep water.
Nze bwe namara okubatiza, ngenda kubula wato genda kuda mukunda ba.
When I baptize you, you may not see me again.
Amazi matufu gali nti encha lwenfulume gwanga lino.
The truth is tomorrow that I'm leaving this country.
Kubanga nze susagaloloze nti nkwebatiriza olina faida nina faida mugwe.
I don't want you to think that I'm going to baptize you because I'm going to benefit you.
Nze kutwala wa Kristo.
I'm just taking you to Christ. And that's where I want to leave you.
Era njagala kugamba nti bwe mbakulese wa Kristo nga yoyo gwe nkusongeddeko.
And when I leave you to Christ, and that is where I point I leave you.
Oyo gobo tunulira.
Just look at Christ alone.
Nze kabindeme.
If I may fail,
nkuyigiriza amazima.
I've told you the truth.
Nkulaza omulokozi.
I've shown you the Savior.
Mwenyewezeko.
Just go tight to your Savior.
Oja kutuka.
And you'll reach the heaven.
Amaso gaje ku bantu.
Don't look at individuals.
Bonna bali mu kanisa muno tebagenda mu guru.
Not all those that are in the church are going to heaven.
Banja bali muno neyenga Satani yebatuma.
Many may be in the church and have been sent by the devil.
Bible yenkakasa negama nti bali baba bibi ne kuchitanda niyo mwali gendo mulalanga.
Bible says that there will be two on the bed, one.
Bible yenkakasa Yesu abayigizo baje ne bamugamba titwasigansigo namu teyali ngano entufu.
And the disciples say that didn't we actually But we found the wild one. Where did it come from? Accept, allow us to go and uproot it and take it out. And he said, don't
touch it.
Let them grow together. Because once you that the wild one, you may even shake the roots of the good one. Let them come together. I will come again. I'll take out my and I'll leave
the
many of you who have come today. You may have come that you are not never
baptized.
But you've been in church. I'm telling you, coming to church does not take it.
Away.
You need to go to Christ and be baptized. I just want to give you a warning. You may be coming to church and worship, but you know what you do. The Lord he could have even condemned you, but he says let
him be.
Don't think he doesn't see, but there is a time
for
unlike the other bad
flowers.
You can change your life and say, Lord, change me.
Nze weekend waliwe binsumbuye birowozo bwe mbadde mpitayita mubakiriza bange.
There are things that have challenged me and to the
point that
there are people who are
in God's church. I almost raised my hand to declare something.
And I almost wanted to cancel the baptism today.
Katampa niko mukono gwange.
I almost felt like raising my hand. Do not play in the Lord's
journey.
If you don't want to go to heaven, do not disturb those who are ready to go. If you don't want to go, don't bring a curse to the church of God. Don't play with God in the time of mercy and you think the time of mercy is still the time of mercy. Check yourself. But the Lord may have brought you. You may not survive today. That's when the Lord said, I've brought you here, the man of God to preach,
so that
bury all your sins and come out of it. I'm calling the Christian who knows what to do.
Yes.
Jesus
is the salvation.
Amen.
And then he finishes saying,
and in the end, in
Acts, he says, Peter saying,
repent.
Let each and everyone be baptized in the name of
Jesus,
so that your sins may be forgiven.
You
will be given the gift of the Spirit.
There are
people have reached out and they say, I'm just about. You
who
have baptized me. Brothers and sisters, you don't know what is
going on.
It is a sad thing that you have come. And you listen to what I've been preaching.
It could
be that it's the Lord who brought you to take that
spirit.
God is not going to destroy you without sending.
You
don't know what will happen tomorrow. Yesterday I was coming from a visitation. And one of the sisters reminded me of Sister Grace Bachaita. I left her. She was a friend of mine. And I know she came. And went to work. And she came back. Not feeling very well. By the time we were taken to heaven, she was going. Never managed to get to the next Sabbath. And I had the news that she is rested. I never heard of the illness. We waited. And then we buried
her.
Brothers and sisters,
at a time as this,
I don't know why I've come at this time. And I told you that I'm preaching today, but tomorrow I'm leaving. I'm not saying that give me the
bread.
I'm not saying give me anything. I've got my own job
there.
And I don't say come unto my feet. And I'm not going to promise any monies or anything. But the salvation is only freely. And I come and preach.
Freely given.
Freely
Amen.
Given.
I give.
Amen. Not everyone that says, Lord, Lord, that will enter the kingdom of God. But he who does God's will. Many will say unto me on the other day, that Lord, Lord, did we not prophesy? Did we not chase the
devil?
Did we not make so many miracles? And some of them were even
gospel.
They'll come out thinking the heaven is there.
They'll
come with the confidence knowing that they are going to
be.
They'll come with a list of the holy things that they've done. They give the offerings, but their name was not in the book of heaven. Then he says, I'll say unto them, I never knew
you.
Get away from me, all those who are making
the
Mark chapter 7 verse 7,
he
says there are many who worship
me Saturday,
on the Sabbath day,
Sunday,
on the Sunday and other days, but they are worshipping me in vain, because they teach the commandments of the laws of people. But the Lord says that those innocent days,
that
but today is calling everyone
Kubanga agamanti yateka wolu nakuruwagenda okusaira mu ensi zonna omusango gw'ensonga.
Ekiseera kijja.
Ekiseera kyo kiyinza okuba eky'obulamu bwo ku nsi kuno oba eky'okujja
kwe.
Kyava amaliriza ng'agamba nti waliwo okuyimirira mu maaso mu musango mu maaso g'entebe ya Katonda. Njagala kukakanya abakatuuka mbaaniriza.
I would like to welcome those who have just come in.
Mwanyina Sister Joan, njagala kuita.
I'd like to call Sister Joan to come.
Nga sina maliriza bubaka buno.
Before I finish my message.
Kampite mwanyina zono.
I'll call Sister Joan.
Aje. Atuwo luimbo lw'enjawulo.
To come and minister to us in music.